Learn how to deploy an application to Azure with GitHub Actions in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. GitHub Actions enables you to execute jobs whenever something happens in a GitHub repository. This helps you to customize your GitHub workflow to whatever you need it to be. This is the GitHub website, and I have opened a repository that contains a simple ASP.NET Core website. Let's create an action for this repo. Here in the Actions tab, I can choose from many predefined templates for common scenarios. I'll choose blank workflow file. This creates a new file called workflow.yaml. It uses the YAML convention. Let me paste my code in. There. So here we create a new GitHub Actions workflow that runs whenever code is pushed to the repo. You can choose other triggers as well, like when a new pull request is created. The workflow contains two jobs, one that builds the code and one that deploys the code to Azure. In GitHub Actions, jobs run on virtual machines, and you can choose the operating system that you want to use to run the job. In this case, that is Ubuntu for both jobs. In the first job, I check out the code using this action. This is a predefined action that I can use, and there are many of them. Next, I make sure that .NET Core is installed on the virtual environment. And finally, I run .NET build on the code. That's cool, right? I can just call .NET here, because .NET Core is installed on the virtual environment. You can also run Azure CLI and other commands if you want. So, when the build job is done, I run the deploy job. It only runs when the build job succeeded, which I configure here. The deploy job has just one step, which is this one. This is one of the Azure steps, and this one deploys code to an existing Azure web app. There are many other GitHub actions that interact with Azure that you can use to, for instance, run Azure CLI commands and deploy apps to Kubernetes. This action needs the name of the web app to deploy to and a publish profile, which contains the URLs and credentials to deploy the app. I get the publish profile from a GitHub secret, which I'll create. I can do that in the repo settings, and here I can add a new secret. It should have this name, and I can get the value from the Azure portal. This is the web app that I'll deploy to, and here I can download the publish profile. I just have to open it and copy the contents, and that is what I'll use as the secret value. That's it. Let's commit this workflow. All right. And it should be running now, as it is triggered by any push to the repository. There it is. Let's see more details. This is the first job that is running. This can take a while, so I'll speed up the video. This builds the code, and when it succeeded, it starts the deploy job. There it goes. When the deploy job is done, it shows the URL of the web app in the output. It is also an output value that I could use in a subsequent job. Let's go to the URL to see if it worked. And there it is, the website running in Azure. There you go. GitHub Actions are a great way to build a continuous integration and continuous deployment pipeline for your code without ever leaving GitHub. Go and check it out.